Amen.
Amen.
Are we blessed?
Amen.
We feel the Holy Spirit, His presence in our midst today. Thank you so much, God. Today, I would like to present to you a woman of God. None other than Sister Rothel.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
Praise Him. Praise Him. Give your clap offering to the Lord. To the Lord. Before we come to the presence of God, we always start in worship. So, I know you are blessed with the worship, but before we pray, I want you to close your eyes, bow your heads, and ask the presence of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We welcome you, Holy Spirit. We welcome you in this place, Lord. Hallelujah. Because of who you are, I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Because of who you are, I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise, praise you. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are, we praise you, Lord. We welcome your Holy Spirit. Lord, you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You deserve our praises, Lord. Lord, you are the creator of the heavens and the earth. You are the creator of your favorite creation, the human race.
Yes,
Father in heaven, we thank you in the name of Jesus, Lord. You are our Jehovah Jireh. You are our Jehovah Nisi, the God of our victory. You are our Jehovah Shalom, who give us unfathomable peace, Lord God, in this world full of miseries, full of everything that we cannot take, Lord God. You are the God of our own, Father God.
Amen.
You are our daddy.
Yes.
Father God, we thank you in the name of Jesus. As you always do, Lord God, we ask your holy presence, your Holy Spirit, Lord, as you always do, to divide your word, Lord God, to each and every heart here, Lord God. And let your word be personal in every person, Lord God. That this is not just a second-hand revelation from somebody, but this, Lord God, will be a personal with our name written on it, Father God. Personal to us. It's a gift from you to us, Lord God. We ask your guidance, Lord God. Hide your servant, Lord God, at your back. Let your glory be manifested. Let your Holy Spirit, Lord God, be seen, Lord God, by everyone. Let your Holy Spirit be felt and your powerful word, Lord God, live in our hearts, Father God.
Yes, Father.
And your Holy Spirit to help us live every day of our lives, Father God. Let your word be powerful and have authority over our lives, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So today we are going to talk about, as whether you like it or not, it is about giving. But it is giving in all aspects of our lives. So our message for today, for you, is our attitude towards God, or our response towards God, our reaction towards God. So this message confirmed with me 3 times, so I believe this is from God. So our text is Malachi 2 verse 17 and 3 verse 1 to 18. So I will read them to you, and I pray that God will open our spiritual eyes and ears and hearts to see the revelation of this word from the Word of God. The Lord said, You have wearied the Lord with your words, but you say, how have we wearied him? How have we quenched him? How have we hurt him? By saying, everyone who does evil is good in the sight of the Lord, and he delights in them. Or by asking, where is the God of justice? Yes, please. Behold, I sent my messenger, and he will prepare the way before me. And the Lord whom you seek will come, suddenly come to his temple. Remember, his temple is our body. The temple of the Holy Spirit is our body. And the messenger of the covenant in whom you delight, behold, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. But who can endure the day of his coming, and who can stand when he appears? For he is like a refiner's fire. Last night we seen a lot of fire in the park when we were having the prayer meeting. So it confused me, the message. This is about refiner's fire. For he is like a refiner's fire and like fuller's soap. Like fuller's soap. He will sit, Malachi 3 verse 3, he will sit as a refiner and purifier of silver, and he will purify the sons of Levi and refine them like gold and silver, and they will bring offerings in righteousness to the Lord. Then the offering of Judah and Jerusalem will be pleasing to the Lord as in the days of old and as in former years. So we will stop here because I want to descend it in descending order. So, we'll start in Malachi 2 verse 17. How have we wearied him? How have we hurt God? How have we quenched God? The Spirit which is living in us. How do we hurt him? I've heard in the Hollywood, many of us watch this movie or series. So they are arguing about which way is really from God. There are many ways that they know. They are arguing about, is New Age away from God? Is Christianity away from God? Is Buddhism, is Islam away from God? But we believe, and I believe, we have no right to ask which way is from God. But the right question is, why a holy God give us a way, one way, to go and return to his presence, which we once were lost? Why have we made a way, the way? Why have we made the way for us sinners to go back to him? Why? This is the right question you should ask. Not which way to go, but why a God so holy come down to die for me and make the way for me going back to his presence.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Why would he do that to a sinner like me? Hallelujah. So he said, behold, I send my messenger, and you will prepare the way before me. And the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to his temple. So it struck me and it dawned on me. He will suddenly come in the temple, whomever he pleases. Just like in the book of Acts. The heir comes to whoever, to whomever he pleases. There is no seeking that is happening. But he is seeking, he is searching for the one whom he pleased to dwell in. This Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit dwells in whomever he pleases. So are we privileged that we are the one chosen, that the Holy Spirit to dwell in.
Amen.
His temple. This is His temple. So, but who can endure? And the messenger of the covenant in whom you delight, behold, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. But who can endure the day of his coming, and who can stand when he appears? It is only those who have given the Holy Spirit, because he is the same Spirit that is coming. Hallelujah. This is what I like here. This is the main text of this. For he is like a refiner's fire, and like fuller's soap, he will sit. He will sit as a refiner and purifier of silver, and he will purify the sons of Levi. Do you remember Levi from Israel? This tribe is offered to the Lord. This is the 10% of the tribe of Israel to be offered, to be purified, so that the whole Israel will be sanctified in the eyes of the Lord. Levi, these are the priests. And do you remember in 1 Peter 2 verse 9, you are a holy nation, a peculiar priesthood. For you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood. Tayo ito. This is us right now. A royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for his own possession. Only his own possession can stand when the Lord comes. This temple. The temple, the whole body, soul, and spirit. And this temple will be glorified one day. This is what we are waiting for. So he will purify the sons of Levi and refine them like gold and silver. So I wanted to tell you about this refiner. Is there somebody who is working in a refinery or mining? So this is what happens in when we are talking about the refiner's fire and the fuller's soap. So in the refinery, they will dig this. If you see some stones in the mining area, some stones, and they are little bit shining from the stone, like a silver and whatever metal is in there, gold or silver, but they are very small. But in big rocks, like this is called ore. So in the refining process, these big rocks will be put in a machine where it will get crushed and became small. And when it became small, all of this will be put again to a one refiner's fire about a thousand degrees Celsius, and they will melt the ore. The refiner will melt the ore, and when the perfect temperature comes, this ore will melt and all will become dust, and what will be left is the silver or the gold. This small, the pure silver and the gold, it is put on fire, refiner's fire. And fuller soap, if you remember, a fuller are the ones in Israel, they are the ones who are making this wool garments. So they have to take away the smell and the oil of the skin of the sheep. So they will process this garment, and they will remove. This fuller soap is very strong, and I found out that the chemical that they are using are very strong, that they have to separate the area of the fuller business. They have to separate because it's so smelly. Do you know what they are using? They are using the scale urine. This is very smelly. So they have to separate the urine, the old urine, the stock urine. It is stock. So they have to separate because it's very smelly. And it takes away the oil, the impurities of the wool. So that this fuller soap will make the wool so white. So white without blemish. And the fuller will stamp on it, on the wool. It will stamp for it 1-2 hours. And then it will he will hang them. And you cannot see a stain. What is good in this refiner's fire? God said he will sit as a refiner. Do you know that if a refiner has to sit and watch what he is refining, what is the fire has to be perfect so that this pure substance will be left or else it will all melt. It will all become dust, but this silver will not melt. The refiner has to see it as the process is going. It reminds me that God has to see it as our refining process is ongoing. Hallelujah. So how did the refiner know that the process is finished? Do you want to know? The refiner knows that the process is finished when he sees his own image in the silver, in the gold.
Amen.
It's ready when it's shining like a brilliant shining silver, and the refiner can see his own image on what he is refining. It represents.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So this purification process is harsh and difficult, the same as our lives. For some, it causes backslide. For some, it causes their faith to decrease. But this process is unavoidable because God wants to take away all the impurities so that this body can represent the image of God in whom dwelling inside of us.
Amen.
So one preacher said, if you're saying you're spiritual and the spirit is not coming out of you, I think you're lying. The fruit of the spirit is coming out. So 1 Corinthians 3 verse 12 to 15. See that God has to, the silversmith will not stop the process, and the fuller will not stop the process until he gets the right reaction of the cloth, the right reaction of the silver. The refiner will not stop doing the same process. Just like in our Christian life, when God wants to take away something in us, the process will not stop until God has seen the right reaction, his image in that situation that you have to react onto. What is your reaction? Is your reaction towards God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So what is our foundation in serving God? Is it our own motivational motive in serving God, or is it something, what is our intention in doing something for God? Let us ask ourselves. Because 1 Corinthians 3 verse 12 to 15 says, the fire, now if anyone builds on the foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, and straw, each one's work will become manifest, for the day will disclose it, because it will be revealed by fire. Every works will be tested on fire. And the fire will test what sort of work each one has done, the intentions, the motives. It is put on fire to prove that your intention is pure. So if the work that anyone has built on the foundation survives, he will receive a reward. If anyone's work is burned up, he will suffer loss, though he himself will be saved, but only through as fire. No reward. But you will smell like a barbecue. So, I pray that God will give you this revelation as He has given to me. What is the connection in this Malachi? Why God is always giving this Malachi chapter 3 to us? What is the connection between God refining us like a silver or gold? And what is the connection of that refining process to giving? And between returning to God and giving, what is the connection? For the Lord, for I the Lord do not change. Therefore, O you children of Jacob, are not consumed, for the days of your father will have turned aside from my statutes and have not kept them. Return to me, and I will return to you, says the Lord of hosts. But you say, how shall we return? How shall we return? See, the connection, I said, God, why returning and robbing God? What is the connection of this? So I asked like that, so how will a man rob God, yet you are robbing me, says God. But you say, how have we robbed you? In your tithes and contributions, in your tithes and offerings. Why? I said, God, what is the connection of this giving and giving tithes and returning? If we would remember, we need to return because man was once lost. We need to return to God because we were once lost. We were all dead in the transgressions. There is a big gap between man and God. So God, as we see, made the way. And He didn't only give 10% of that way. He gave His full deity of being God. Come down on earth as a man. Bring the way. Died for us. 100% of His being God and being man was crucified on that cross for you and for me.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. So 100% God has given Himself His own possession, His only Son. Not 10%. But God is asking 10%. Why? I'll tell you why later. So this refining process, God is refining us because if He is the God who dwells in us, it will reflect the image of the refiner to his silver and to his gold. What is the connection? If He is really the one who is living in you, He will reflect outside of you. He is a giving God. He is a giving God. He didn't only give 10%, He gave His own Son.
Amen.
Whom He has. All He has. God has given 100%. And now He is asking of 10%. So if He is the God that living in us, we would not be burdened in giving because this will be a natural manifestation of God in us.
Amen.
We will love to give because God is inside of us.
Amen.
And manifesting Himself outside of us. He is not only good in copying Himself. He is imitating Himself because it is naturally coming out because it is Him who is doing. So He is showing whom He really is if we will allow Him to move in our lives. He is a very gentle God. He needs our permission to move. In salvation, we don't have part. But in being a gentle God, He needs a permission to you and me so that He can move in our lives. So if He is really inside of us, natural love will flow. Do you know what is the meaning of love? Natural love will flow because He is not a thing. He is love itself. God is love itself. And it says here, 1 Corinthians 13, 14-7, love is patient. He is patient. I'm not patient. God is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. He does not boast. He is not arrogant. He is not rude. He is not rude. He does not insist on his own way. Not irritable. He does not rejoice in wrongdoing. He doesn't record wrongdoing. This is God inside of us. It is Him. And He bears all things, believes all things, and endures all things. If we have all things in the world, but we don't have Jesus, if we all have knowledge in the world, if we all have the giftings in the world, but if we don't have Jesus in our lives, we are nothing in this world.
Amen.
Amen.
So, it's all about Him. If He is really inside of us, we are allowing Him to rule in this temple. And you will see yourself giving, because He is a giving God. It will manifest. You will not withhold, because He will not withhold for His own body, the church. He will not withhold for Himself. So now, when the process is of refining of our character is finished, the refiner would see clearly his own image after he puts you to the furnace of fire. God will see you. God will sit on the process that He will make sure that you will not burn out in that process. He will make sure that our reaction, until He gets the right reaction to us, building us in His own image, then He will stop the process. Or if we don't allow Him to do this process, we will stay on the same area of our lives and we will not move. We will not grow.
Amen.
We have to allow God to have this process in our lives. And this world will see a shining silver and gold and the image of the God whom we serve reflecting outside of you, because the seed of God is inside of you. This is the seed of God reflecting Himself outside. So whatever we do in our lives, whatever we say, this is the God whom we serve inside of us.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So the world can see whatever we are doing, whatever we are saying, it reflects whom the God we are serving. So now if we reflect on our lives, if we see our lives, evaluate how we have reacted to the people around us. When God puts you to test under His refining process, how did you react when you hear the word of God? I want you to meditate on this question in our lives, to evaluate our lives. How did you react when you hear the word of God? Did you apply it? Did you do it? Or did you just make it enter here and pass over there and just walk away just the way you are? How did you react? So until you are having the same reaction that God doesn't want, you will stay in the same place of your spiritual life. So how did you react in every person? Something like when I know somebody just not here, always putting me like you know, you making you so small that it's outside the word of God when people are putting you down. The Lord said, be blessed. You know, a real blessing is not about you have many money, Real blessing is not about in this world. Real blessing is when somebody pulls you down, when somebody persecutes you. The Lord said, be happy. Be happy. Thank God. Thank God in all circumstances. So, I want you to realize how you need God in our lives. Sister Ami, can you please stand up? What do you feel? What do you feel right now? So do we need any power in standing up? If God takes away that power, can I stand up?
No.
In sitting down, can I sit down when there is no power of God in me?
No.
Do I owe many things to God that I can sit down in somebody lying on their bed for their lifetime? Can I thank God when I don't have money but I'm not have a maintenance over my heart disease for the whole rest of my lifetime? Is it so? Is it a good thing to think about to God? So in every circumstances we need God. Many people in this world owe their lives to God. Everything in this world owes something to God. But whether you like it or not, God has chosen you. God has saved you, whether you like it or not.
Amen.
And one day will bring you to in His kingdom.
Amen.
So, how did you react when God asked you to give up something? How did you react when God asked you to give 10% of your hundreds? How did you react when God asked you to give 10% of your thousands? And how would you react if God asked you to give 10% of your millions and your billions? If you cannot give in your hundreds, how can you give to your millions?
Amen.
Hallelujah. So why are we always saying this one? Am I doing a fundraising here? Hallelujah. Philippians 4:17 said, it is for your increase. It is for your benefit that when you do this, this is the promise of God. Malachi 3 verse 11. This is what happened. I will rebuke the devourer for you, says the Lord. I will rebuke the devourer for you, so that it will not destroy the fruits of your soil. Isn't it clear? That when you give, God is protecting everything you have. I will rebuke so that it will not destroy the fruits of your soil, and your vine in the field shall not fail to bear, says the Lord. Then all the nation will call you blessed. Malachi 3 verse 13 to 15, it says here, how have we spoken against you? We are talking about your attitude towards God, your reaction towards God. What is the profit of keeping His charge or of walking as in mourning before the Lord of hosts? What will be profit if we serve God? How have we spoken against God? How have we reacted against God? What have we done to God? What is the reaction we have given to God? Matthew 25. Matthew 25 verse 34 to 40. Jesus said, come you who are blessed by my Father. Come you who are blessed by my Father. Inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me. I was naked and you clothed me, I was sick, and you visited me, I was in prison, and you came to me. The righteous will answer him, saying, Lord, when did we see you are hungry, and fed you, and thirsty, and give you drink? And when did we see you are a stranger, and welcome you, or naked, and clothe you? And when did we see you sick or in prison and visit you? The Lord said, and the king will answer them, truly I say to you, as you did it to one of my least of these brothers, you did it to me.
Yes.
As you did it to the least of the people in this world, whether he is a Christian or not a Christian, you do it to God. Whatever you speak towards other, you do it to God. You speak it to God.
Amen.
So one day we will stand before God, and what have we done? We will take account of that. What have you said? You do it to God. Why did you say this to me? When, Lord? When did I say that to you? When you said it to the least of my people. When you do that to the least of my people, you do it to me. Hallelujah. Your response to God is your response to other whom you see. How can you love God whom you see? Whom you did not see, while others that you see, you cannot love, you cannot give, you cannot respect. I will end a little bit, 5 minutes maybe. So, to keep people in your house, how did you react when God asked you to keep people in your house? How did you react when God asked you to forgive those who hurt you? And how did you react to give yourself when asked God you to give yourself to His kingdom so that you and your family and the people that surround you will be saved when you say yes to God?
Amen.
How did you react when you are close to somebody who is very smelly? When I'm meditating on this verse, sorry God, when I was in the elevator, sorry Lord, that's how we react to God. It's a simple situation, but this is true. Our reaction is our reaction to God, whether it be big, whether it be small. So when you say it behind me and you say it not to me, but you say it to God. When you give to the church, you don't give it to the church, you give it to God. When you listen and you don't argue to the authority above you, you don't listen to and argue with that authority, but you listen and you argue with God.
Amen.
This is our reaction, our response toward God. Everything we do, everything we say, it is not for anybody else you do it, but you do it to God Himself. As a closing, I got one story for closing. So one daughter, she is married. She got a messy week. The boss get angry, the car broken, the grades are not good, and the thing that she is baking, it's burnt, and the file lost in her computer, in her job, then everything is messy. Then she got a fight with her coworker, and she just go to her grandmother, worn out. Say, Grandmother, I cannot take this week anymore. Can you help me? Can you give me some advice? And the grandma laughed at her. And the grandma told her, okay, come here in the kitchen, watch me. The grandma boiled 3 pots of the same boiling water, the same level of boiling water. The grandmother boiled 3 pots of boiling water. One pot she burned out, she boiled carrots. One she boiled egg. One she boiled coffee beans. The grandmother told her what she is in their perfect time, I'm gonna off them and we will see what will be their reaction in the same level of boiling water. Then the time comes, ting, the oven ting, and then she offed it. And then they took out the carrots, took out the egg, and pour the coffee in the cup. So the grandmother told her, "What have you observed about the carrot? Before you boil it, it's very hard, but now it is very, very soft. How about the egg? Its shell was hard, but it is liquid and soft inside. But when we boil it in the same level of boiling water, it becomes very hard inside and out. And the coffee, when it boils, it smells a good aroma. That they drink the coffee and it is very nice. This is the same purifying process God has given us. Our reaction, when we are hard to God, He will make us soft. When we are soft to God and to the people, He will make us hard. And He will make our offering and ourselves a sweet aroma offering to the Lord as the coffee beans as He boil it and make that aroma come up to Him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So this is the word of God for you. What is your reaction?
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Rothel, and praise God for that. Sorry, it's only a number. It's fine. So we came here with a heavy heart.
Yes.
Some of us, we came here with a heavy heart. Bitterness, full of bitterness, not bitterness. Bitterness. But now, praise God, we have a clear and filled heart with the joy of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. It's time to testify.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for the message of our pastoral hotel. It says that kung ano po yung ating pinapakita sa tao, siya po yung ating ginagawa sa Panginoon. Time to testify. Sabi sa 1 John 1:3, we proclaim to you what we have seen and heard, so that you also may have fellowship with us, and our fellowship is with the Father and with His Son, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Remember, our purpose is to share your experiences with Christ in a loving and caring, as well as in a convincing and convicting way, so others can start to have an interest in wanting to know Him, the Lord Jesus Christ. Testimony about relationship with Christ and how He has met the deeper needs in your life about your family, work, friends, everyday's life with Jesus Christ. Remember, bad or good are blessings to us. Remember, the Lord says, all things together work for good, and Romans
8:28.
Yes! Yeah. 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 Must be the world.
Good morning, everyone. I would like to give a testimony how God saved me last Thursday, Wednesday night in the evening, 8 p.m. I was going to my cousin's house in Dubai. And when I went out to the gate and waiting for the taxi, there is a taxi coming with me. I didn't ask them to come and say. And I was in a hurry because it was a night. And I was a little bit afraid because I am new in that place. So when the taxi came, and I didn't notice that there is somebody inside. So I ride directly. And then when I opened the door and saw that there is another guy inside the taxi, I was about to return. But the taxi big restaurant. So he took me from that place. There is two bad guys that I really scared, and I don't know how. I was told that that was my last time. This is my last in the end of my life. And I was praying, and they attempt me to be arrested. They go around in the fireplace, and they hold me and tie me in my two hands and forcing me to unclose. I just pray and cry. I say, Lord, if this time is the end of my life, I give you my life and save me. I cried. And I was begging the two guys. I said, please, I'm begging you, return me back to my home. And they said, we just want something from you, and we will let you go. And then I was in that place in Alcamanich area. It was very far. And I was crying. I said, I just said, Lord, save me from these two bad guys. And then I don't stop praying. I keep on praying. And how God saved me. He heard my praying. And I cry, I beg God. I'm begging them, please. If you need something, I don't have anything. If you just need something from me for your happiness, okay. Just let me go back, because I have children. And maybe God's touched them hearts. They don't do anything for me, and then return me back to my home.
Really bad experience. That is a blessing to our God, because it testifies that God is alive.
Amen.
Our sister. Who was the other one to testify? There is one more.
She's ashamed, so on behalf of her, our sister, can you start, sister? That sister, last week we prayed for her she has feeling for the about the breast. And you remember I testified that God healed me instantly when I was in the Holy Fire Church, that there is a speaker pray for healing. And I am the one also lay hands on him last time. Pastor this next soon. Oh, yeah, pray for her. And she was took something in her breast to check, general check if there is cancerous or anything. So we pray for her, and I cleared the last time. I agree, pray that what you help from the Lord, because the experience I had is a sign of breast cancer. As a nurse, I knew the signs that you have that ill in your body. So I was very amazed for her, and she said today, because I asked her, and the result, she took the result yesterday, I think yesterday, and everything is clear. Normal! That is good! Hallelujah! So thank you, Lord, for our sister. So if we remain faithful to the Lord and we ask his name, he will answer.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. There is power.
I call in Brother Asher?
Yes.
For an explanation, please.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Parents, are you happy?
Yes.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Everybody feel the presence of Lord Jesus?
Yes.
Holy Spirit, thank you, Father Jesus. As everybody knows, me and my family, the God is chosen to us. So He is the one who will announce this, and I am the one who will pray. Amen. So God will bless everyone here.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Greeting everybody to all of you in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What time is it?
It's giving
time. Offering time is blessing time.
Praise the Lord.
Bible tells us in book of Deuteronomy chapter 16 verse 16, they shall not appear before the Lord empty-handed. It means whenever we come to house of God, we have to give offering to glorify our Lord.
Amen.
Therefore, Apostle Paul tells in 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 6 and 7, but this I say, who sow sparingly will also reap sparingly.
Yes.
And who sow bountifully will also reap bountifully.
Yes.
So let each one give as he purposed in his heart, no grudgingly or no necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus, heaven and earth. You are the word of God, you are the mercy of love and the Lord of God. Let it shook the Rasal Kamabala. My Lord, my God, in the name of Father, in the name of Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ, my Lord, my God, the Bible says, my dear son, I know you are running behind my sheep. I know you very well. And when you are the belly of your mother, I am the one who choose you. My Lord, my God, my King. If you are the chosen to me, my Lord, and you promise to me, wherever you go, I will go with you. My God, my Lord, my King, in the presence of your Lord, my God, in the presence of Holy Spirit, in the presence of Jesus Christ, who I am with you. मैं तेरा शुक्र करता हूँ रावा संता रावा साबाबा लतिया रत सबा नीति हितिया रत संहा माय लॉर्ड इफ यू कॉल मी एंड यू चूज़न देन ब्लेस दिस चर्च इन द नेम ऑफ जीसस ब्लेस दिस पर्सन टू माय लॉर्ड ब्लेस दिस territory, increase your boundary, increase your people, bless the children of Israel. Bible says, if you bless the nation of the Israel, I will bless you. Amen. My Lord, my God, my King, by the authority of Lord Jesus, by the authority of Lord Jesus, I bring in front of you this offering and tithe, my Lord. Bless this offering and I bless your children and let them glorify your name, my Lord, my God. In the name of Jesus. Nobody will go to hell. Hallelujah. Rasanta Balati. We are the Son of Aha. Bless their children in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Aleluya. Please listen for the following announcement. We urge everybody to know his Bible study, where he belongs to, and make sure he attends. Praise the Lord. Okay, our prayer meeting will be announced on our webpage, UCF webpage and chat. Praise God. Then we all will meet at the Capital Park, where we meet last time for our preparation, so that we go to the beach. Amen.
Amen.
Then we have to welcome our visitor, the soul that God has brought to himself today. So we welcome Sister Lassie Salon. Hallelujah. As she's coming out, we owe God a hand offering. Amen. Sister, you're welcome. So where you find yourself, it's like today God search all around and see only you brought you today on Hallelujah. So we are telling you that you are not mistaken to come here or to be here today. It's only by the grace of God that God brought you to himself today. So where you saw yourself today is UCF, United Christian Church, United Christian Preaching, where the word of God is sold as you have had today, where the word of God has sold raw, understand, without any dilution as you have had. Praise God. So today you are a visitor, but from now on you are a member. Praise God. Bingo. So So we ask you to be coming every Friday. Then our pastor will pray for you, and the church will also welcome you as we normally do.
I believe last Friday we have some visitors also, which were not being recognized from your brothers.
Yes. There are some brothers last week that we supposed to welcome them the way we need to do. But maybe last week, because of some certain things that we have, we couldn't meet up to that. Please, if you are among, please, you come at the front, but we welcome you officially as we need to do. Please. I'm forgetting your name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are welcome.
I believe one of the brothers, his name is Kenneth, right? And we have fun last Friday in the park. If you want to see the fun, just visit our page, FB page, and you will find how happy the children of God are. And what's your brother? His name is Valentine. So, their names sounds like Americans. Kenneth, Valentine, and Agustin. So today, we welcome you once again for this church. United Christian Fellowship, we call it United because we work not only for Filipinos but to all the nations, every town and every town. And we request everyone to please rise as we bless these brothers and sisters. Let's extend our hands to release the blessing. Amen. Once again, Father, we thank you for this wonderful day. Thank you, Lord God. This is not a mistake. This is not an accident that you brought, that these people, these brothers and sisters, oh God, are here this morning. It is part of your purpose, oh God, for their lives. Father, once again, I pray. We pray, Lord God, as a church. Right now, Father, we declare blessing upon them. We declare, Lord God, that, Lord, their lives, Lord God, will never be the same again. There will be a real change, Lord God. Lord, going to your direction of the Lord Jesus Christ. Make them just like you, Father God. I pray, Lord God, right now, minister to their lives. Minister to each one of them. Open their hearts, open their minds, Lord God, that they may see, Lord God, the beauty of serving you. Father, this morning we pray in the name of Jesus. Let your blessing overtake them. And everywhere you will go, whatever they will do, Lord God, you will bless. Bless the work of their hands. Bless, Lord God, all the people around them. Yes. And make them, Lord God, a blessing not only to their colleagues, but also, Lord God, to their families back in the country, so God. Yes. Father, today we pray, Lord God, Lord, the best blessing that you will be able to receive is by accepting you as their personal Lord and Savior. Lord, visit them in your perfect time, oh God. And you will come into their hearts, Lord God, as their Savior, as your God. And Lord, I pray right now, Father, for this sister, for these brothers, oh God. Lord, I pray for salvation, Lord God, for each one of them. We declare, Lord God, that they belong to you.
Amen.
You are their God, and they are your people, oh God. Amen. As a church right now, Father, we thank you, Lord God, for all that we're going to do in their lives, oh God. And allow them, Lord God, to start a journey, Lord God. A journey, Lord God, that is pleasing to your sight. Thank you, Jesus. We want to give you all the glory and honor in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Oh,
Praise the Lord. Let's continue standing in the presence of God as we come to our final exchange and minister. But before that, I would like to make some announcement that after this service, we're going to the Capital Park to prepare for going to the beach, because today we're going to have a baptism, a schedule for baptism. And we have four candidates this afternoon to be baptized. And it will be announced. Can we announce today their names?
No, the
mother's
name is pretty hard.
Anyway, next Friday we're going to award or to give to them the certificate of baptism, so they will be recognized in front. Amen. So I think one of them is Brother David Daniel, right? To be baptized. Sister Myra, Sister Jonah, and what else?
Patrick.
Patrick. So we have four candidates. So let's give them a welcome. Praise the Lord. So now, we'd like to let everybody to be in the mode of prayer as we come to the Lord this morning, and to end the service in prayer. Father in heaven, Lord, we thank you for this morning. Thank you, Lord God, for the victory. Thank you for your words, O God, that you bestowed to your people. Thank you, Lord God, for the blessings, spiritual blessings, Lord God, that you shared to us. Thank you, Lord God, for bringing people to this church, O God. Thank you, Lord God, for all the things that you have done and for all the things that you are going to do to this church, O God. We are looking forward, Lord God, for a better and more blessed ministry of God. And Father, this morning, Lord, as we depart from this place, let your people of God be united, Lord God, in spirit. Be united by one heart, by one mind, O God. And let your spirit, Lord God, unite us, Lord God. And you have said in your word that, Lord, let love and faithfulness never leave thee. Bind them about their neck. Write them in the tablets of their hearts. Father, this morning, Lord, I pray and I declare, Lord God, Lord, bless your people. Amen. Continue, Lord God, to be with them wherever they are. Yes. Whatever they will do, Lord God, bless, Lord God. Let their barns be filled with plenty, Lord God. Amen. Let their finances overflow, Lord God. Yes. Lord, you will meet every kind, Lord God, of need, Lord God. And I declare right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, by the authority, Lord God, that is written in your words, Lord God, that your blessing will overtake your people. And you are going to enlarge, O God, your territory, O God. Father, we declare, Lord God, this day, from this day, Lord God, your people will not suffer, O God, any loss. Amen. But Lord, they will enjoy the benefit, Lord God, of being your children, O God. Fully loved, highly favored, O God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let us raise our hands for the benediction. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling, and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory, with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forevermore. Amen. God, we pray for the food. Once again, Father, thank you, Lord God, for the blessings, Lord God, that you set before us. Sanctify this food, Lord God, for the nourishment of our bodies. Lord, as we continue, Lord God, fellowshipping with one another, allow your people to enjoy having this blessing, O God, around these tables, O God, and continue, Lord God, to be with us as we fellowship with each other. Yes. Bless, Lord God, this restaurant, O God. Bless the people who prepared this, O God. And we want, Lord God, to enjoy today, Lord God, the remaining activities, Lord God, of this for today, O God. Be with us, Lord God. And even, Lord God, as we go to the beach, Lord God, you're going to keep us safe, O God, from any harms and dangers. This is what we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. 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 Amen.